I am who I am and I am where I am because of it.
How do you know you've become one of the all-time greats? When a sport has new rules to keep you from winning too much. That's exactly what's happening to Simone Biles. The iconic gymnast continues to push the bounds of gymnastics and physics. The five-time Olympic medalist is so dominant that the rules of elite gymnastics intentionally put her at a scoring disadvantage. In an effort to deter other gymnasts from trying skills they are not physically capable of doing, the International Gymnastics Federation watered down the value of a new element Biles plans to do. It really shows she's in a league of her own.
One day down the road, I'm not going to be able to do it again, and I'm going to wish I could.
Ever since her debut, Simone Biles has been dominating her competition for her entire career. You may think she's already crushing her opponents, but she could be crushing her opponents by even wider margins, if the higher powers of gymnastics would let her. Even years after her monumental Olympic debut, Simone Biles is still pushing her limits. The four-time Olympic gold medalist made history at the US Classic 2021 when she landed a Yurchenko double pike vault. The feat is so challenging and dangerous that no woman had ever dared to try it in competition before her. It's a notoriously dangerous skill that takes a lot of skill to pull off. The authorities of elite gymnastics awarded Simone a score on par with many of her other, less difficult vaults. The 24-year-old gymnastics superstar pulled off a feat so notoriously complex and dangerous that no woman before her had ever attempted it in competition, but wasn't awarded for it in score. The Yurchenko double pike requires a gymnast to complete a round-off back handspring entry into the vaulting table and then execute two full backward rotations with legs extended before sticking the landing. Biles has spent months mastering the move in training. It's very, very challenging. And what's scary is that people can get hurt. You do a short landing, you can hurt your ankles. It's a very dangerous vault. One of Biles' coaches, Laurent Landy, said, "Biles certainly doesn't need to take the risk of this magnitude to find success at this point in her esteemed gymnastics career. But instead, she's choosing to push herself heading into the Tokyo Olympics, her final swan song. Without that motivation to reach new heights, Biles' final year as an elite-level gymnast would become very, very boring for everybody." With more world championship victories than any other athlete in the sport's history, she opened everybody's eyes to the fact that this can be done, proving females can do it too.
And I feel like that's what motivates me.
Rather than athletes earning points throughout a performance, the decision makers at the International Gymnastics Federation pre-assign scores to routines based on the difficulty of the skills involved. Then judges evaluate execution in real time, docking points from the potential total every time a gymnast makes a mistake during their program. Every element in gymnastics is assigned a letter, which corresponds to a numerical value. An A skill is worth a tenth of a point, and every letter in the alphabet that follows is an additional tenth. So a D skill is 4/10 of a point, while the rare J skill is worth a full point. Biles is doing two new skills at Worlds, a triple twisting double somersault on floor exercise and a double twisting double somersault dismount off a balance beam. The triple double was valued as a J skill, while the double double was only deemed to be an H. Because Biles regularly achieves physical feats other gymnasts can only dream of, the degree of difficulty associated with her routines, particularly on floor, balance beam, and vault, are assigned some of the highest possible scores. Biles enjoys a huge margin of error as a result, so she can get away with faltering during a performance because her floor is higher than most of her other opponents' ceilings.
It's been a lot of fun, but it's been a lot of stress too, because there is not only me.
They had an open-ended code of points, and now they're mad that people are too far ahead and excelling, Biles said after the US Classic. This US Classic vault wasn't the first skill the 24-year-old felt was undervalued by the Federation. Ahead of the 2019 World Championships, Biles expressed how pissed off she was over the gymnastics governing body's unfair valuation of her eponymous balance beam dismount. Am I in a league of my own? Yes, but that doesn't mean you can't credit me for what I'm doing, Biles told NBC Sports at the time. They keep asking us to do more difficulty, to give more artistry, give more harder skills. So we do, and then they don't credit it, and I don't think that's fair. Gymnastics leadership blames restrictions on safety, but Simone and others suspect otherwise. She suggested that the FIG has seriously undervalued her skills because they don't want the field to be too far apart, she told the Times. But there's another force at play, and it's one Simone acknowledged during the fight over her balance beam dismount 2 years ago. Rewarding harder, more dangerous skills with significantly higher payouts may make athletes take risks. For other elite gymnasts, many of whom are still teenagers, experimenting with dangerous skills can become lethal with the smallest of mistakes. In response to Simone's critique of her balance beam dismount valuation in 2019, the Federation leadership insisted that encouraging athletes to put themselves in harm's way would be irresponsible. After widespread criticism of its decision, the Women's Technical Committee, WTC, released a statement explaining its reasoning. In assigning values to the new elements, the WTC takes into consideration many different aspects: the risk, the safety of the gymnasts, and the technical direction of the discipline, it said. There is added risk in landing of double saltos for beam dismounts, with or without twists, including a potential landing on the neck. But why does Simone continue to aim so high? Simple, for her. Now it's just for myself, she says. In addition to the difficulty score, the sum value of all the elements in a routine, there's also an execution score. If a gymnast insists on trying a skill he or she has no business doing, she gets a low execution score. A normal E score for an elite gymnast is in the 8s or 9s. But a low E score will cancel whatever advantage there was in the added difficulty. I'm almost 99.9% sure if any other athlete were to do it besides me, they would give it correct credit, Biles said. But since I'm already way ahead of everybody, they want to pull it back. But in the gymnastics world, people are acknowledging her feats. This is an incredibly difficult dismount, and you make it look too easy. Cecile Landy, who coaches Biles, said on Twitter, "Keep doing you." Straight out of quarantine, Simone has wasted no time proving that she's still at the top of her game. The Olympic gymnast posted a video of herself debuting a new move, a triple-double dismount off of a balance beam. In the video, which Biles shared on Instagram and Twitter, she does a few back handsprings before executing the impressive dismount into a foam pit. A triple-double involves twisting three times and flipping twice before hitting the ground. You've probably heard the term used in relation to Biles before. During the 2019 World Championships, she became the first female gymnast to do a triple-double on the floor in competition. The move got named after her. But this is the first time Biles has ever demonstrated the triple-double dismount off of a balance beam. The video is insane on its own. Apart from the fact that Biles hadn't even trained with her team for weeks while she was quarantining, it impressed some of Biles' fellow Olympians, naturally. What? Nastia Liukin commented on the Instagram post. Iconic, Lori Hernandez wrote. Other commenters joked that if Biles ever does the move in competition, the International Gymnastics Federation will probably undervalue it. We're excited to see Biles bring women's gymnastics to new heights at the Tokyo Olympics. We'll be cheering her on, will you? Do you think Simone Biles is one of the greats? Do you think it's unfair to her to be graded less? Let us know in the comments. For more videos like this one, subscribe to The Thing Celebrity.